debate competition 2020. We are really excited to hear our participants and wish that this event be the best remarks in our memory. The room is ready and the tables are set. So let's start with our awaited Padma Shri Dr. NNDN National Debate Competition 2020. We welcome you all. Now I request the respected participants to introduce themselves without revealing their name. They can kindly introduce themselves by introducing their DAB number and their motion.
So who will introduce first, Shraddha?
I'll ask DAB number 11 to introduce herself.
Okay. Is it me, DAB 11?
Kavya, kindly on your webcam or else we won't allow you to participate. Okay, thank you.
So Shraddha, who is DAB 11? She is asking.
DAB 11, is it me, Kritika? It's not Kavya.
Yes, Kritika, you are DAB 11.
Okay. So Kritika, introduce yourself and start with your arguments.
Okay, my name is Kritika. I'm from MIT and I have to speak for the topic. So I believe it is necessary for us to have free testing in India. Because first of all, we need to
Kritika, sorry to interrupt. It's just an introduction and after that, ma'am will allow, we will speak. Okay, all you need to do is just introduce yourself.
And you don't need to mention your institute.
Only your DAB number and your motion size. Go ahead.
So my DAB number is 11 and just introduce, I don't have to name my college.
You are not required to name your college. You can speak about the course you are pursuing.
Okay, I'm Kritika and I am pursuing BBA LLB Honours from, that's it.
Okay, fine.
That's it.
And now I would like to ask the DAB 42 to introduce herself. Kavya, kindly introduce yourself.
Kavya, I think you're on mute. You need to unmute yourself.
Am I audible now?
Yeah.
Okay. Hi, I'm Kavya. My DAB number is 42 and I'm pursuing BBA LLB right now. I'm a second year student.
I would like to request ma'am, Sonal ma'am, to ask any of the participants to start the debate.
DAB 11, you can start with your for motion.
Okay, so I stand for the motion because in a country like India, which has a population of 1.3 billion people, a mass number of people cannot afford to, get the testing done, which is for 4,500 rupees. You know, per testing is that much. Some people earn that much in a month. So it is impossible for people of lower strata to get that testing done. People of higher strata or middle strata still can think about it. Secondly, testing is important because it helps us identify the location. So if more number of testing is done, we are able to identify more number of coronavirus cases. And we can lock down that place and activate the place where there are no cases at all. Activate green zone. So it is going to help our economy. At the same time, it is also going to, lock down the places which are necessary. But at the same time, because currently in India, we are locking down the entire country, which makes no sense. It does not contribute to our economy. We have to open up wine shops to get taxes. So it's really important to identify the cases in order to identify the locations. Secondly, we should prefer people before humans, people before our economy. You cannot put economy first. Economy is because of us. Economy is because of people who are in India. You cannot think about profit-making mechanism or putting economy first or earning revenues from businesses. So it's really important to think about the people. Think about in a humanitarian way. We need to think about our citizens. And it comes with more expensive consequences. If you are not able to identify the cases first and get it treated, we'll have to pay more amount of invest more amount of money in getting the mask, getting the sanitizer, or getting the ventilators or beds. Right now, we have converted our railway stations, our train bogies to, in order to make them, equipped for people with coronavirus cases. So it's really important that we identify, lock down the place, and get the treatment done. Otherwise, we'll have to face expensive consequences later on. So that's my point.
Amman, is her time up?
No, ma'am. She still has time.
We have still left 1 minute and 30 seconds.
Do you all want right. to say anything further? You have 1 minute and 30 seconds.
Yeah, all right. I can come up with one. So another reason is that on humanitarian ground, it is contradictory to right to life. We are not giving people of lower strata, daily wages, worker employment. We're not giving them employment because of the situation. It's not that the government does not will to. We don't have the opportunity. We do not have the situation does not allow us to give that opportunity to in order to make people earn. At the same time, we are keeping test valued at 4,500. So it's completely contradictory. You want them to get tested, get the treatment done, but at the same time,
you still have a minute left.
You have only 20 seconds left.
Okay, 20 seconds left. Sorry.
So it's completely contradictory and against right to life. That's what I feel.
Okay. We can hear you, Kavya, against the motion.
Okay. I strongly believe that free medical treatment for COVID-19 should not be given. In the wake of the coronavirus breakout, medical testing for COVID-19 has been prioritized. In this way, we can find the infected people before he came in contact with each other. And let's see the major comeback for making the free medical testing of COVID-19 funds, which is a major requirement. The impact of COVID-19 pandemic and the lockdown has triggered financial market visibility. The pandemic has pushed the economy into the recession, which means economy starts shrinking and growth stops. And some of the strongest economy around the globe are struggling to cope up with the situations. Shutdowns of all the key economic activity that drives the growth. And there are five major sectors which needs to be urgent, which needs urgent help. First one is MSME sector. It is literally the backbone of the all Indian sector and often engages in the manufacturing and export economy. And MSME is really under the crisis and has no done.
You have 3 minutes left.
Okay. And MSME has made no money to pay for the employees, and also MSME are out of the actions due to the lockdown. And next sector is tourism and hospitality sector. This sector has hit so hard and lost more than 3.8 crore jobs because of the movement of the people is restricted. And the next sector is aviation sector. Aviation sector connects nation across the world, and some workers were asked to take a forced unpaid leaves by aviation companies, who has been hit really equally hard as tourism and hospitality sector. And aviation sector lost over 66% of the wake of the coronavirus. And next comes the automobile sector. It is a key manufacturing activity and had led to the sharp letdown in the production and sales. Most of the plants shut, and the big automobile manufacturing companies has been announced pay cuts. And the last and the final is that real estate sector. And real estate sector has suffered immensely suffered due to the lockdown, and major construction projects has been put on hold for several weeks, and this leads to unemployment among millions of migrants labor who engaged primarily in the construction activity. And all these like major five sectors has hit really hard, and it takes 1 or 2 years to come back to its normal position. And when all these sectors describes the position and the status, and all these sectors describe the position and the nature of the India, and and everything is falling apart. And the government has to look into these aspects also, not just like giving a free medical testing. And also the next thing is the infrastructure for the proper treatment for COVID-19 patient. It is necessary to facilitate a high tech infrastructure for COVID-19 patients, and also to educate the staff in taking care of them. If the rate of the corona affects the people, raise the number of the beds and ventilators used in the hospital. And the final thing which I wanted to tell is that one of the major reason for taking up the test because people are carelessness. The people are not quarantining themselves. Government are taking many steps to prevent the corona affected people by lockdown. But still, people take it carelessly and make government pay for the mistakes. And people take it granted in case of the free testing. And doing test is not so easy. The result takes 48 hours, and once they pay the price, the people will take it due care to protect themselves. And I strongly believe that like pre-testing should not be given. And thank you.
Okay. Deb 11, you can proceed with your rebuttals. And after rebuttals of both the sides, I'll have a few questions.
Okay, first of all, the aviation and all of data is not required. Right now, we are talking about free medical services, pre-testing done. So it is not required. Secondly, you said when people will pay, then they will realize. But I'm a daily wage worker. I earn 60 rupees per day. How will I pay?
You would have actually made some savings for your future. So if you are not careless and you would have quarantined yourself properly in the home,
you think 4,500 is like a small amount? A daily wage worker who can get only a square meal per day, he can save that much for a pandemic? Were we ready for a pandemic? It came like nobody's business. Nobody knew about this pandemic. How can you imagine a small daily wage worker to prepare for such pandemic with 4,500 rupees? And in a family, there's not only one member. A normal family has almost approximately four people. You cannot anticipate that all of them will save up 4,500 each. So it makes no point here.
Deb 11, are you done with all your rebuttals or do you have any further? Then Deb 42 will give rebuttals of your rebuttals. Do you have any other point to rebut?
Yes. So she's not going to talk right now?
She's going to talk after you finish all your rebuttals. Then she's right now making note of your rebuttals. After that, she'll rebut each rebuttal wise or something like that, however she wants.
Okay, no, let her do it. Let her counter.
Okay, because I think, Shraddha, does she still have time?
Yes, ma'am, she has.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
I have the time? Okay, yeah, I thought it would be too and fro. All right, so that was my first question. They do not have enough saving. Secondly, it should be made free for the lower strata. The upper strata people can still pay, but it should be free for the lower strata people. And right now, as I said, even in the ceremony, like, our Ansari Chief Justice Ansari said it's all important to
1 minute left.
Okay, it's always important to think about the people. They are also contributing to our economy. They are also contributing in construction work or agricultural site. You cannot expect them to save up that much and not get enough. The basic requirements run. That is a test. They will get the test in. So they have two options, either to get the test done or eat food. They'll die of hunger if they did not get the test done. So do you understand? It's like the basic thing, basic medical health that matters to us. So it should be made free in this situation. I'm done with my rebuttals.
Okay, Deb 42, you can continue with your rebuttals.
Okay. The first thing which I want to tell is that if the worker is quarantined himself carefully and he has taken a due care protection, why would he take testing in the first place? And the next is that do you think the private hospital or a private hospital or any other nursery can take up this challenge, and like will they be able to cover up to like 4,500 to a one patient? And even though the government gives support, they can't cover up that much. And like the third thing which I wanted to ask is that, do you think like people take this granted if it is given for free of cost, and they get tested and get hospitalized for no reason even after government has given them enough awareness, and after like people take this free testing for granted, don't you think it's a complete waste for the economy, like complete waste for the government to pay 4,500? And even like this might end up in a great economic depression. First of all, we are in the economic slowdown, and after for paying 4,500 for each person in a country like 1.2 billion people, paying 4,500 for each person, it's impossible. And there is no way that if a person takes a due care and awareness, there is no way that he get affected by the COVID. And how much time do I have?
Shraddha?
1 minute left.
1 minute is left for you. Do you want to say anything further?
Yeah, okay. And my opponent has mentioned that profit making mechanism, which I didn't hear it properly. Like can she like elaborate what does she mean by the profit making mechanism?
Ma'am, is that permitted?
I don't think so. She can answer such questions directly.
Sabri Patel is not a part of this.
That's not a part of it, Kavya. You can continue with either your further rebuttals or. If you have anything further, you can say that.
Okay. I think that's it.
Ma'am, okay. Any clarifications you want to ask from the participants?
Yes. So she said that people will take it for granted. First of all, it's not a piece of cake that people are willingly going to take.
Sorry to intervene. Your part of rebuttal is over. Now it's ma'am's part. If you want to ask any point of clarification, she can. Your part of rebuttal is over. As per the policy, we have provided you the policy, right?
Okay, I thought I'm supposed to answer her. She said
no,
something.
No. There is no sub-rebuttal. Okay.
All right.
Okay, so I have one or two questions for you. Let's keep it very brief, maybe like a minute or so. So my first question to you is, what exactly are you proposing? Are you proposing that it be free for everybody? Because that's what I understood from the first part of your speech. But from your rebuttals, I understood that you want to make it free only for the rich, only for the poor, and you want to charge the rest. What exactly is your contention?
I mean, people of rich class can afford it. So it makes no sense to make free for them. It would be like an exploitation of our economy. We should make it free for people of lower strata, which was not clarified in a recent Supreme Court judgment. But now that, you know, the proceedings and all the arguments that has been held in this recent Supreme Court judgment, they have clarified that it is made free for the people of, you know, under poverty level, BPL level. So it's okay. Free for then, them. It should be made free.
I have two more questions. Let's keep it very, very brief. My second question is, when you say it should be free, whether the government will bear all the cost, including for a person who has an insurance, or whether it will be distributed amongst the insurance company and the government?
So talking about, if you know about insurance law, it does not cover pandemic because it happens on a whole. And they do not cover any risk that happens on a whole. But still, there are few companies that are supporting. So we should let the companies who are supporting this pandemic situation, and the rest should be covered by the government.
If I understand it correct, I think there was a guideline by the government which said that all insurance companies need to pay for the pandemic as well. Like, I mean, should not exclude COVID, saying it's a force majeure. You should include pandemic, and you should pay where rightful claims are there. So with this view in mind, I mean, I think if I'm up to date, that's what the status is. So then what is your view? What do you think about that then?
I mean, if you know about few cases that happened in the past, insurance company won't exist if they start insuring each and everybody in this pandemic, because we are a country of 1.3 billion people.
Okay. I'll get to Kavya for her questions, and then we can wrap it up. Same, you have like a minute or so. So Kavya, question to you is, you have said that, you know, various sectors have been affected and various jobs have been lost. How do you think then these people who have lost their jobs, although they don't really fall into the below poverty line category, how do you think they will be able to afford such a high cost of testing by themselves?
One second, like I didn't understand your question. Like, you are asking me that, like, who are not under the poverty line, how will they be able to cover up the costs?
So I'm saying, as you mentioned, that there are various sectors that have been affected because of the lockdown and there's an economic slow. So say, for example, I am in hotel business, and I'm one of the employees, but because the hotel business is shut for now, I am either laid off or I have to take a salary cut of say 50% or so. Then how would I be able to pay for my own? First question is this.
I'm sorry, I seriously didn't understand it. I'll just
ask you next. Aware of like asymptomatic cases that happen in coronavirus. And cases that happen in like a lot of doctors who, in spite taking precautions, are still getting coronavirus.
Yes.
So my question is, your argument was that workers or whoever should be made to pay, because if they'll be made to pay, they'll realize and they'll be more careful. But in our country, doctors are really very careful. They are wearing PPE, they're wearing masks, they're wearing, like, you know, face shields and everything. And still they are facing coronavirus cases and they are dying from coronavirus. So just by taking precaution, it's not in a, like, people are not in a position to escape from coronavirus. Then, you know, in that case, you have like, just give her 30 seconds to explain.
Okay, like doctors, they will be like, they will be like working with the COVID-19 patients. So there are like all, like almost like all the chances for them to get affected, even though they have taken up precautions. But you can't compare the doctor with a wage people who take this lockdown so carelessly.
Ma'am, that's it.
Okay. So Shraddha, yes, we are done with the arguments.
So thank you, dear participants. Now I request our faculty coordinator, Mrs. Deepa Srivastava ma'am, to give the vote of thanks.
So since we have met with the adjudicator ma'am in the earlier session also, so I would like to thank her as well as the participants for sparing time and gracing this occasion with their presence. So let's see who wins, and wish you all the best for the next level. So now I would like to request participants to leave this meeting, and we will continue with the adjudicator ma'am. Thank you so much.
Thank you for being here.
Someone brief time to the ma'am. What was the time taken by both the participants?
Yes, ma'am. The time for Dev 1 is 3 minutes. Yes, ma'am.
Shraddha, you want to say something?
Ma'am, please close the recording. Ma'am, please close the recording.
Okay. Just a minute.